Hey Virgo, welcome back to the channel. This is Kelly from House of Virgo doing your love reading for this time period that you're listening into November 2022. Let's get into this reading. Please do like, share, and subscribe if you enjoy my channel and my readings and personal reading links and all other links are in the description box below, okay? So just be mindful, some of the messages may or may not resonate. Take what fits, leave the rest. Hi, everybody in the chat. All right, you guys. So I already started your reading and I had to stop it because my cards, my deck was sticking together. So again, and I have used all of your tips and tricks and yeah, well, honestly, it didn't work, so I'm going to figure something out. I'm going to use a Witch's Tarot deck tonight. So anyway, the cards that came out, Photograph, Healing Heart, and Heart with a Key. So I feel like someone is looking at your pictures or they are seeing you in their mind's eye and reminiscing, being nostalgic, missing you. And this energy feels to me with the Healing Heart card that it is incentivizing someone to heal their heartbreaks, okay, heal their pain, to free themselves from toxic behavior and addictions, okay? And if that resonates for you, well, that might be your message, okay? Heart with a key. I feel like there is somebody here, and is this somebody that you are romantically connected with, or is it a friend? We shall see, but it is a romance love reading. Heart with a key, this feels to me like this person wants to connect with you, okay? Wants to get together, wants to welcome the love that you offer to them, all right? Now, the three cards that fell out with the Tarot, we have the Ten of Cups, the Six of Cups, and the Lovers. So there is an energy here of making a decision to reconcile and live happily ever after. This, and I know that sounds so cliche to say, but this feels like an energy of somebody who is ready, willing, able, and motivated to come into union with you, okay? After healing any type of an addiction or heartbreak or toxic behavior, okay? Definitely, all right? I feel like, okay, that's your reading. See you later. I feel like there's a big change that's being made. This Lovers feels to me like twin souls coming into union, being open and vulnerable and connecting. Gemini energy there. And I know you guys, Gemini has been in these readings like nobody's business. I don't understand what's going on, but Gemini all over the map keeps showing up. So I know some of you are like, I don't want the Gemini back. That's fine. It doesn't have to be a Gemini. It's an energy of communication, okay? It is Mercury ruled with the Lovers. It's talking. It's getting together. It's being open and vulnerable and transparent with one another, being truthful, speaking from the heart, okay? Somebody also may want to reconcile a marriage, not get that divorce. Be a family again. Bring the children back together again. Okay. Let's see what else is going on here. All right. Okay. Five of Pentacles. So there's definitely an energy here. This person is in this position and or going into this position in November where they are really weighing their options. In other words, is it better to just be in a stark cold environment and not have to worry about a relationship? Or is it better to come into union with you? Because I feel like right now this person is standing out there all by themselves in the cold. It's barren. It's a wasteland. There's no love. There's only freezing cold snow. There's barely any fruit on this tree. And I feel like this person has not provided the fruits of their labors. They have not provided good fruit, okay? Perhaps in the past or just in general. So I feel like somebody here is taking whatever fruit they have provided and they are basically weighing out, is this enough? This is making a decision here. Has what is what I offer to a love relationship enough? Was it enough? Okay. Was I only... I feel like, so this person is holding two pentacles and there are five pentacles here. I feel like this person was offering, how can I say this, to collaborate, but it may have felt to you, or it may feel to you like this is more of like a work partnership or colleagues or friends and no romance. Okay. And why? Because I think this person may have been weighing their options to see, and I hate to say this, but it has nothing to do with their feelings for you. It feels more along the lines of, is this the right person for me? Is there compatibility? I feel like chemistry is there for sure. And I do feel like there is an attraction and there is love, but it boiled down to this person. Are we compatible? Can this work? And I feel like this person is coming to terms with, yes, this can work, despite any obstacles, despite any feelings of, I guess I want to say, a poverty mindset of isolation or financial loss or a sense of feeling like not well enough to be in a relationship. The sun here is a positive. That's a yes. That's success. So overall, it feels like this person is coming to terms with, you know, I really do love Virgo, or will come to terms with that in November. Virgo is my other half. Virgo is my person. And yes, I know I'm ready to make this work. Okay. But we're going to take a look at you too, Virgo, and see what your energy is. We also have a Leo on the table. So we'll see what's going on with you. I feel like it might feel good for some of you to know that somebody really does love you and they want to try to make this work, but I don't know, I just kind of get this sense that some of you might be on the fence about it at this point. Okay, got the star, Aquarius energy, okay, and there's you, male or female energy, Queen of Pentacles. Right now, Virgo, it seems like you're healing. You are on a path of renewal at this time. And I feel like you are very focused on stabilizing yourself. You may not even have it in your mind to be ready or to be willing, right? Why? Because you had some kind of a heartbreak, or there might have been betrayal, or arguments, or a separation or a divorce, okay? Maybe some depression. Some of you, I feel like, are on the mend at this point. You're still healing your heart. Even if it's a new love coming in, some of you are kind of like, I don't know if this is something I'm ready for. I want it, but I don't know if I can do it. So it feels like, Virgo, you might not be motivated to get into something too quickly at this time, as you're focusing on, like I said, your healing. That star energy is, you know, it's a real strong sign of getting your hope back. Some of you are waiting for a miracle. You're trying to get that inner clarity, okay? And regaining your faith. And I feel like that's good, right? Because what good would you be in a relationship with anyone if you weren't stabilized, if you weren't over somebody else, or, you know, whether this is someone new or a past relationship returning? You know, Virgo, you, I feel like for you, your message you're saying to yourself is, perhaps I can't start fresh until I've cleaned this slate within my heart, this residual leftover, maybe some pain, emotional pain, okay? But Knight of Cups, you do eventually want to have that. You may even eventually want to have that with this person, okay? But you don't want someone who comes in with that knight. If they're going to do the Knight of Cups, where they're going to come in and make an offer and then follow through, yes, that's what you want. But if somebody's going to come in with the Knight of Cups and sweep you off your feet and then leave, you're not I just feel like you know how it ends, Virgo. You know how the story ends, and you know you're looking for that bloody stumps, you know. And until then, single is a Pringle and doing you, and that's a good place. Okay, are they going to follow through though? I think they will, but I also feel like that's what you're going to be looking for. And that's what you want here, making that connection, a mutual understanding between each other, coming in with that love offer and getting on the same page. Okay, that is where you're at this time in your life. And I feel like, Virgo, some of you, you're not taking less than that. You're not even interested in a friends with benefits. You're not interested in just friendship. You are wanting to make that soul to soul love connection. That Two of Cups is that soul to soul mutual understanding, romantic love, partnership proposal, and or even marriage. Okay, so you know, I don't feel like you're blocking yourself though. I feel like you're open if love comes in, but I don't see you rushing to make that happen or to secure that at this time. You're very focused on your healing and cleaning up whatever baggage of the past, okay? Three of Pentacles. That's what that person left you, right? You're not looking for to be in a romantic relationship here with someone where it just feels like you are, like you work together, like you're just partners. You know, you're looking for romance. You want love, affection, hugs, and kisses. Listen, Virgo, I do feel that this person, either if they're new coming in, there is going to be a love connection made, okay? And whether that's new or old, I do feel like the love that this person has for you is much deeper. It could be a Taurus. It could be another Virgo or a Capricorn. I feel like they do have very, very deep love for you. It's more than just romantic love. I mean, it's deep. It's like coals burning deep, okay? And or they will come, you know, going forward for you, okay? Yeah, you're a wish come true for this person, I know. And some of you, or at least you will be when you connect with this person. You know, you guys, sometimes I feel like these messages are exactly the same. I really do. And I feel for you because I know some of you are like, when is this going to happen? When is this going to happen? And, you know, all I can really say is divine timing. Okay. I feel like somebody here, if you already have a connection with this person or you met them sometime around September, that's when this person has come to terms a month ago that you are the one for them. Now, why? Maybe there was some absence. Obviously there is, because this person, I feel like, is missing you. What is it going to take though? I mean, what is going to be the catalyst for change for this person to come towards you and to make this love offer? Let's take a look here and see. All right. Yeah. This person wants to win your heart. They must be very competitive. They could be competitive in a lot of ways. You know, that six represents loyalty and responsibility. This person feels responsible. If you knew them in the past for causing any distress or not treating you, not infusing love into the connection, but it feels, you know, so I'm not going to say that it's ego with the Six of Wands in the upright. I do feel like if it was in the reverse, I do feel like this person, it would be like lack of confidence and their ego would cause them to come back, but I'm not feeling that at all. I feel like this person wants you to see them as a winner. There is an energy that perhaps you don't see that in this person. Some of you might have even called this person a loser, which I hope you didn't do that, but you know, you're human. Sometimes that happens. Maybe a little friendly fire now and then, you know. And I do kind of feel like this person, if that happened or if they feel like you view them that way, they agree. They agree, you know, and I feel like they don't want to be in that. They don't want to be viewed that way. They don't want you to think that way about them. Okay. They want to be the, I need a hero. They want to be your hero. They want to be your heroine. Is that how we say it? Heroette. I don't even know. I'm making up words here. Whatever. It's my channel. I'll do whatever the heck I want. Right? So, Ace of Pentacles. Yeah. There is an opportunity here, definitely, to come into union. But Virgo, just because the opportunity comes doesn't mean it's for you. I don't want to get into too much of a deep psychological thing, but I just feel like you're not settling, you know, and I don't feel like you feel like, it just feels like you know your worth, you know what I mean? Like, and if you're not in that position yet, you're getting there, you know what I mean? Like, that's what that star is. You're seeing yourself as, you know, you're a superstar. I know that's not the lyrics, but I'm making it up. So, the World, Page of Cups, and the Page of Pentacles. Yeah, Virgo, the tides are turning for you. You are on a new path, and I feel like you're just kind of starting over with the Page of Cups, you know? Kind of like, there's definitely communication. If you make the change, I do feel like you're going to get some kind of communication through the internets, you know, or through your phone, like maybe a text. Whenever I see the page, I always feel like pages, there's some kind of offer or a communication of someone telling you their ideas and plans or what they want to do. Okay. Libra energy here. You also have Scorpio energy with the World. And I said the other signs for that. So I feel like somebody wants to do right. You know, they want to balance things out. Okay. So, I mean, hey, it's good for them, right? Because they want to do that. But I don't know. Some of you do want that to happen. And others, some of you may decide not to go through with a divorce because of this, you know, because of what this person comes in and says with this vulnerability and opening up and being transparent. Some of you may find out that this person is actually going through with a divorce as well. And for others, this person, let's go get hitched. Let's go to Vegas. You know, that kind of quick and fast. Let's just go before the judge. You know, let's take it to the courts and let's get hitched. I know that may not be romantic, but it does feel kind of like a change in spontaneous behavior from this person. There you go. The Chariot. It's telling you go. Don't waste any more time. I don't know if this is go for it or leave the situation, but whatever the situation is, don't waste any more of your time on frivolous pursuits. Just do it. Go after what you want. Blockages are definitely going to be removed during this time period. And I kind of feel like you guys, you know which path you want to go. If somebody's coming in with that offer for you, don't ponder it for too long. Take a risk. Just do it. Just do it. Okay. And if for others, like, don't be on the fence. State your case as if you're in the court of law. State your case. Say exactly what you expect. Say exactly what it is that you want and that you're seeking. If you do the, well, I'm not sure, the universe is going to give you someone who's not sure. If you do the, well, let's see how it goes, the universe is going to come in and just give you a very broad range of paths. Be specific and exact with people, places, and things, and spirit, and say exactly what you want. That's how blockages are being removed, because then you don't waste time on details and frivolity. You get right to the heart of the matter. You see your vision and you put yourself in a position to have that vision actualized, and you see it through. You manifest, you see it through. And I'm not talking about manifesting a person. I'm talking about manifesting your desires, the things that are best for you, okay? And I feel like for you, Virgo, you know, it's, you know, I guess what I'm really picking up is the energy of you. I understand that love comes in, love goes out, and some of you have been in an off and on, can't find anybody, whatever. But when you're focused on yourself, you attract the good that's in you, okay? Rather than focusing on what you don't have, when you focus on what you don't have, you're never going to be satisfied because you don't have it. But if you focus on what you do have, you will feel the abundance. Do you understand what I mean? And not compare yourself to what other people have. There's sure there's people your age who already have children and you don't. There's people your age who have been married and you haven't been. It's not a sprint. It's a marathon, and everything is in divine timing. And your timing has nothing to do with somebody else's timing. And once you accept that that's where you are in your life, you know, you have the power to make those decisions. Okay. You are the judge and jury of your own life. Well, underneath God and all the forces and supernatural powers that be. Okay. So I feel like, you know, Virgo, for you, it might be, and don't shoot the messenger, but it might be time for you to get off the fence and make a solid, hardcore decision, right? Because some of you are sitting, and some of you I know might be just waiting for someone to make a move, but you know what? Some of you are waiting for closure, but you know what? You got to give it to yourself. You have to be the one to set the standard for yourself, what you will and won't accept in your life, right? You have free will. You can do whatever you want. And you have to be clear and honest with yourself. That way you'll be clear and honest with other people. So you have Year of the Ox showing up here. I feel like the Tiger shows up a lot. So here it is again. Year of the Dragon. Year of the Snake. Year of the Horse. Year of the Rabbit, Year of the Goat, Year of the Rooster. So this could be you, could be your person, could be both of you, could be neither. Just take the message as it resonates. Let me get a couple of love romance angels to see what other messages there are here for you. The overall message, though, what I'm picking up is, despite whether someone's coming in to give you that love or not, you have to decide. It's up to you to decide if you want this or not. You can't be in a position and say, well, this person gave me all this love and then they took it away, right? Maybe they do, but you have sovereignty. You're the one who has to take accountability for certain things in your life, your decisions. No one can make you do anything unless you give them the power to do that. And then it's still your decision because you're giving them the power. Okay. Bloody stumps, you guys. Bloody stumps. And if you don't know what that means, I'm sure, hop into the chat. There are people here who have been with me from the beginning, and they know exactly what I'm talking about. Okay. Romantic feelings. So your feelings are real and worth exploring. And I think that that's something that you need to do, is identify how you feel about a person. About the relationship, your feelings and your affection for someone. Make sure it's true. Make sure you're being true and honest to yourself about how you feel about another person. I feel like whoever this other person is, they are exploring how they feel, which is a lot of the reason why the love offer is coming in here to you. And it might have a little bit of yesterday's reading as well, worth waiting for. Divine timing. And this is what I was saying. I feel like everybody's always in a rush to get to the end. I know I used to be that way. Just wanted to secure it. Just wanted to get to the, rather than enjoying the journey, just wanted to get to the end result as fast as possible. And I'm telling you, that is just not a life to live. Enjoying the journey, enjoying and trusting in the process, taking the scenic route is the way to go, okay? Let me see here. All right. codependency addictions are affecting your romantic life. So there is, like I was saying in the very, very beginning, somebody here is healing some addictions or toxic behavior that has had an effect on you. And it may cause codependency in you. And this person, definitely codependency. It could have a lot of the reason why, if you were involved with this person before, why there was a lot of in and out, on and off, back and forth energy. That's codependent, toxic. Codependency is toxic. Okay. All right. So I feel like I'm going to do just a couple of charms and then I'm going to move on from your reading. Tomorrow, I think I'll do like an extended. I'll see how that goes. I'm going to do the Celtic cross. Let me get a couple of charms. So oh, gosh, hold on, you guys. Hold on. Oh, okay. So, black swan. Beautiful. So, I'm feeling like black sheep. Somebody feels like a black sheep of the family. That could be you. This could be another person. Somebody here feels like the odd one out. Somebody feels weird. They feel uncomfortable. They feel awkward. They feel like they're not good enough. They feel like they're different and they're not part of. Somebody just kind of feels like they're not, like a misfit. I just heard the word misfit. Somebody feels like a misfit. And I feel like that's, I don't know who that is. A misfit when it comes to love. I feel like someone keeps misfiring or they keep missing the mark. It's like they want love so much, but they deny it. There's a lot of self-sabotaging that happens, mostly because somebody doesn't feel like they deserve it. Wow. This is the first time I ever got this charm. We have a pumpkin sitting in a pumpkin patch. I know you guys can't see it, but you trust me. And also a very beautiful little cross. Wow. So, you know, the fall, definitely November. And they're also just telling me with this black swan, different is beautiful. Different is unique. Different is the strange, the special, which makes someone unique. Different is the many markings, the battle scars, someone who is not a carbon, a cookie cutter copy of everybody else. There's a uniqueness to someone here. And is that you, Virgo? Or is it this person? I feel like when someone feels like they're not part of a team or they're left out in the cold or they feel abandoned, there's a tendency to really believe that. But I feel like in a situation like that, it's so important to look, to turn inward and look at all those great special qualities. Yeah, we're not all made the same. It's an illusion to think that we are all exactly the same. It's our differences that make us so beautiful and that make us unique and special. I feel like you see that also, Virgo, in the ones that you love, the people that you fall for. I feel like you tend to fall for people who are unique, maybe artistic, special, different, maybe even a little weird and awkward. But I feel like you wouldn't have it any other way, Virgo, because you are a realist. You see beyond the veil. Not many people do. You're not interested in keeping up with the Joneses, so to speak, or you want different because you feel that way. You feel unique and you feel special as well, but it's not in like a narcissistic way. It's just you fly under the radar a lot of the time. I feel like spirit is just pushing these words out. These are not things that I would normally say to people when I talk to people, but I feel like you fly under the radar because you don't want to be tagged or labeled as being exactly like everybody else. You want to be known yet unknown. Does that make sense? You are the you are the one that rushes in to save someone when they fall on the side of the street. And then as soon as they're up and feeling better, you just walk away. You don't want credit. You don't want thanks and congratulations, awards or ceremonies. You're just there to do the angel's work. You're just there to serve. That's the sign of Virgo, okay? But you're also keenly aware that you can only help those who are willing to help themselves. Otherwise, codependency kicks in, and then you're doing it for them. People need to stand on their own 2 feet, and you're always going to be there to help people get up, but you won't walk for them. And if you've been doing that, I see like you're healing from that. So this reading, I'm taking a break. This was something. I'm going to leave it there. Okay. I'm going to leave it there. And I feel like for you, Virgo, make your decision when love walks in this door. Okay. Make your decision. Is this person capable of meeting me halfway? That's really the question. Are they motivated? Are they willing? And are they capable? Forget the love, because love is love. But can they do it? That's where the decision's being made. And if you turn around and say, you know, I don't think this person has all three of those, not exactly in that order, despite how much you and this person love each other, you have to meet halfway. You have to come together to make something happen, to make the magic happen. And if somebody is not capable, for various reasons, if they're not willing and they're not motivated, then cut your losses, Virgo, because you still have you. You still have that healing, okay? Stay in faith. But I do feel like October, November is going to be a significant time for a decision for you to make, because you are going to be presented with an offer, okay? And they just said, if you're planning on carving your pumpkin, carve a heart in the pumpkin. Put a heart in the pumpkin. That's what they're saying. I don't know why. That's kind of cute. Maybe something if you have children or grandchildren to do that with them. All right, I'm going to leave your reading there. I hope that was, I don't even know what I hope that was. I hope it helped. How about that? So I will see you guys tomorrow. Have a fantastic evening. And yeah, talk to you soon.